Second method of improvement of performance of simple gas turbine cycle is reheat or reheating. So as you can see in the figure 1, it is simple open cycle gas turbine. Process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression, 2 to 3 isobaric heat addition in the combustion chamber, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion in the turbine, and 4 to 1 isobaric heat rejection if it is closed cycle, or simply heat rejection if it is open cycle. This simple open cycle gas turbine is also represented on PV and TS chart. Cycle 1, 2, 3, 4 in green represents ideal cycle, whereas cycle 1, 2 dash, 3, 4 dash is actual cycle considering the component efficiency or isentropic efficiency of compressor and turbine, where 1 to 2 dash is actual compressor and 3 to 4 dash is actual expansion. Now in reheating, what we do, now in turbine, in simple open cycle gas turbine, as we can see here, gases after expansion during the process 3 to 4 are made to exhaust. Gases are made to exhaust because after expansion their pressure is reduced and temperature is also reduced. And with this reduced pressure and temperature conditions, they cannot be utilized in the turbine for producing required work output. So what we do in reheating, we resupply the heat to the gases after expansion in the first stage of turbine and again made to expand in the second stage of turbine. That is called as reheating. So in figure 3, gas turbine cycle with reheat is shown, where process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression in the compressor, 2 to 3 isobaric heat addition in combustion chamber 1, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion in the HPT, where HPT is high pressure turbine, so it will produce some work output. W suffix HPT, this compressor will consume compressor work. Then 4 to 5 after expansion of the gases in the high pressure turbine, at state 4, gases will be further passed through the combustion chamber, where once again fuel will be burned and temperature of the gases will be increased. Okay, pressure will be remaining corresponding to the expansion pressure after high pressure turbine. Then after passing through the combustion chamber and adding the heat at constant pressure in the combustion chamber 2, again temperature of the gases will be increased. Temperature at state 5 is ideally supposed to increase equal to the T3. Okay. Means what is the ideal condition of supplying heat and increasing the temperature in the combustion chamber 2, T5 should be equal to T3. This is the most favorable condition. So gases after passing through the combustion chamber 2 will again made to pass through the low pressure turbine during the process 5 to 6. Further, their expansion will take place and work output will be produced by low pressure turbine. and after expanding in the low pressure turbine, gases will be exhausted to the atmosphere. So 6-1 is heat rejection process. So as you can see here, in the reheat cycle, we use two combustion chambers, one between compressor and high pressure turbine, and another between high pressure turbine and low pressure turbine. Similarly, we use two turbines. One is called as high pressure turbine, another called is low pressure turbine. High pressure turbine basically is used to drive the compressor. Whatever WHPT is produced many times, WHPT is entirely consumed by the compressor. And the low pressure turbine, the power output of the low pressure turbine is connected to the generator and it is used to generate electricity. Okay, so this way the reheat cycle works. Now let us represent all these processes on PV and TS diagram. So let's say P1 is the pressure inlet to the compressor, and this P2 is the compressor at the outlet. P2 is the pressure at the outlet of the compressor. Okay. So point 1 represents initial condition, that is compressor inlet condition. So 1-2 is isentropic compression. At this moment I am talking only about ideal processes, that is reversible process. Then same process can be represented on TS diagram by vertical line. Then 2-3 represents isobaric heat addition. Pressure will still remain equal to P2. P2 will be equal to P3. Here heat will be supplied. Here work input to the compressor. Same process is represented on TS diagram by a curved line, because on TS diagram constant pressure line is represented by curved line. Then 3-4 represents isentropic expansion in the high pressure turbine, and that expansion is done up to some intermediate pressure. Let's say that intermediate pressure is, I don't know that pressure right now, let's say this intermediate pressure is Px. Okay. Then 4-5 once again represents isobaric heat addition to the gases. So it will be once again constant pressure process. Pressure will remain constant to Px. So process 3-4 can be represented on isentropic TS diagram by this line. 4-5 represents isobaric heat addition, and as I said, the T5 should be equal to T3 ideally. Then 5 to 6 represents isentropic expansion in the low pressure turbine from pressure Px2, the compressor inlet pressure P1. This represents PS line. So from 5 to 6, and finally 6 to 1 represents heat rejection at constant pressure. Okay, so this way I can represent all the processes on PV and TS chart. So during 3 to 4 process, work output will be produced by high pressure turbine. 5 to 6, work output will be produced by low pressure turbine. So this way I can represent the PV and TS chart for reheat cycle. Now, what effect this cycle is going to produce actually? Now remember, had there been no low pressure turbine, let's say there is only 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 processes only. So it is nothing but open cycle gas turbine. And work output produced by this open cycle gas turbine will be represented by this. This process 4 will extend up to pressure P1. And area under the curve on PV chart with 1, 2, 3, 4, let's say A, will represent work output produced by open cycle gas turbine. Similarly, on TS diagram, area under the curve 1, 2, 3, 4 and A will represent heat supply to produce required work output. Okay, but in reheat cycle what we are doing, we are employing an additional turbine which is producing additional work output. So from this diagram it is clear, this hatched area on the reheat cycle represents extra work output we are getting because of the additional turbine, low pressure turbine. And to get this extra work output A456, we have to supply extra heat input, isn't it? So this is because of reheating. So area, hatched area on the PV diagram represents extra work due to reheating, and hatched area on TS diagram represents extra heat we supplied to get the extra work output. So what actually reheat cycle does, it increases work output outrightly. Now what about the thermal efficiency? Thermal efficiency generally, ideally it is said that it does not affect the thermal efficiency, but there is a change in thermal efficiency because we are supplying extra heat in the combustion chamber too. We are burning extra fuel to get extra work. So thermal efficiency will also decrease, but that increase or decrease depend upon whether work output increases more than the heat supplied. So we are not sure actually what is the effect on thermal efficiency. Okay, but I can straight away say that due to reheating, work output is going to increase straight away. Correct? So this way I can explain the working of reheat cycle.
So if you don't have any query, I can do the analysis of this reheat cycle. So let us do first analysis of simple open cycle gas turbine. So as you can see here, the work output in case of simple open cycle gas turbine is H3 minus H4. Okay, W net will be W turbine minus W compressor. So it will be H3 minus H4 minus H2 minus H1 kilojoule per kg. In terms of enthalpy difference, in terms of temperature difference, it will be Cp if I take the specific heat of air and gas as same. This will be T3 minus T4 minus T2 minus T1. Okay. Similarly, heat supplied QS will be H3 minus H2, or Cp T3 minus T2 kilojoule per kg. And thermal efficiency will be W net over QS. Okay. Let's say this is equation number 3. Now, gas turbine cycle with reheat. So if I talk about the net work output of the cycle with reheat, WT minus WC. Now turbine work output consists of work output from two turbines. One is from high pressure turbine, another is from low pressure turbine minus compressor work output. In terms of enthalpy difference, WHPT, as you can see, it is nothing but H3 minus H4. And WLPT is H5 minus H6, and compressor work is H2 minus H1. So H3 minus H4 plus H5 minus H6 minus H2 minus H1. So in terms of temperature difference, considering a specific heat for air and gas are same, T3 minus T4 plus T5 minus T6 minus T2 minus T1. Let's say this is equation number 4. Then heat supplied in case of reheat cycle will be heat supplied in the combustion chamber 1 plus heat supplied in the combustion chamber 2. What is that? H3 minus H2 and H5 minus H4. So it will be H3 minus H2 plus H5 minus H4 in terms of temperature difference. T3 minus T2 plus T5 minus T4 kilojoule per kg. Let's say this is equation number 5. And finally, thermal efficiency of reheat cycle W net over heat supplied in the reheat cycle. So as you can see here, if we compare the net work output by simple gas turbine cycle from equation 1 and net work output from reheat cycle from equation 4, W net RH is more than W net simple gas turbine cycle by the amount T5 minus T6, which is due to addition of low pressure turbine. And heat supplied is also more in reheat cycle as compared to heat supplied in the simple open cycle gas turbine, if we compare equation 5 and 2. So, comparing equation 2 and 5, we get net work output of reheat cycle is greater than net work output of simple cycle. Similarly, comparing equation 4 and 2, and comparing equation 2 and 5. Heat supplied in reheat cycle is also more than heat supplied in open cycle. So W net is more than the W net for open cycle gas turbine. Heat supplied is also more than heat supplied in open cycle. So I can say now, if I take the thermal efficiency, W net is also increasing and QS is also increasing. So thermal efficiency will not increase abruptly. There will be marginal increase in the thermal efficiency of reheat cycle. Okay. So thermal efficiency increases marginally, because in order to get the extra work output, we have to supply extra heat input as well. So thermal efficiency may also increase or decrease. So the main
motto of reheat cycle is to get increased work output. So here I can sum up. Reheat increases W net. Thermal efficiency almost remains same. Okay, so this way you can analyze reheat cycle.